Hi guys, in this video I'm going to tell you about the router ID election. Basically, what are the criteria through which a router ID is elected on a router? So the criteria are mentioned on the screen. So basically there are three criteria. So the first criteria is the highest preference is given to the manually configured router ID, and it's very simple to configure the router ID manually. You simply have to go to the routing process and then you have to run the command router ID and the ID which you want to select. And router ID is basically 32-bit number, like it looks like a IP address, okay? And the highest loopback interface IP. If you have not configured the router ID manually, then automatically the router will select the highest loopback interface IP as the router ID. But if there is no loopback on the router, then the third priority will be given to the highest physical interface IP, okay? So let's see this thing with an help of example. So in the first case, this is a router, okay? So let's the router ID is elected manually, which is 1.1.1.1. Now this router is not going to consider any other criteria and the router ID will be 1.1.1. So let's suppose if there is no router ID manually given on the router, then what will happen? Let's suppose this is a router in which there is no manual configured router ID, then it will do the election on the basis of loopbacks IP. So the loopbacks which will be having the highest loopback IP will be your router ID. So in this scenario, this particular IP is highest, so the router ID of R2 will become 20.20.20.20. Okay, but yes, if there is no loopback interface as well, so in step 3, if there is no manually configured router ID and there is no loopback interface on the router, then the router will check the physical interface IP. So the IP with the highest, the physical highest IP will be elected as your router ID. So out of these three, which is the highest IP, I believe this is the highest IP. So automatically for this, the router ID will be elected as 14.1.1.1. So this is how the router ID election takes place. Again, and see the last statement. Once router ID is elected, then the re-election will not take place until we refresh the routing process. Means once the router ID is elected, even if there is a highest IP loopback come onto the router, then as well the router ID election will not take place. If you want to do the re-election of the router ID, then you have to clear the routing process. Then only the router ID will be elected again. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope the router ID election is clear to you guys.